Hi there, Spark fans, Rob Reynolds here. Movement is a fundamental aspect of life. I mean, for people, sure, but also for projects. Robotics, drones, even structures need to be able to measure and even control movement. And a 9-degree of freedom IMU is great for that. 9DoFs are incredibly useful and versatile, but they're not good for any project if you can't get your hands on one. And with current lead times at about 52 weeks, it's getting really difficult to get your hands on one. But what are we as a community? We are engineers, we're makers, we are creative thinkers. So here at SparkFun, we started thinking, what is it that makes up a 9DoF? Well, you need an accelerometer for pitch and roll, you need a gyroscope for rotation or yaw, and you need a magnetometer for gravitational force and direction. And while we might not be able to get our hands on 9DoFs right now, we can get 6DoFs and 3-axis magnetometers. And 6 plus 3 equals the new SparkFun Qwiic 9DoF IMU Breakout. This new 9DoF Breakout combines the ISM330 DHCX 3D Digital Accelerometer and Gyroscope from STMicroelectronics with the highly sensitive MEMSIC 5983MA triple-axis magnetometer by MEMSIC. The ISM330 is an always-on 3D accelerometer and 3D gyroscope. It offers a plus or minus 2, 4, 8, and 16 3D accelerometer with selectable full scale, and a plus or minus 125, 250, 500, 1000, 2000, or 4000 DPS 3D gyroscope with extended selectable full scale. It has an operating temperature range of minus 40 to plus 105 degrees Celsius with embedded compensation for high stability over temperature. These boards offer 6-channel synchronized output, a sensor hub feature to collect data from additional external sensors, and embedded smart first-in, first-out up to 9 kilobytes. It has a programmable finite state machine to process data from the accelerometer, gyroscope, and external sensors, as well as a machine learning core. Additionally, it has multiple smart embedded functions and interrupts: tilt detection, free fall, wake up, 6D, 4D orientation, click and double click, as well as embedded pedometer, step detector, and counter functions, plus an embedded temperature sensor. The MEMSIC 5983 magnetometer can measure magnetic fields within the full scale range of 8 gauss with 0.25 milligauss or 0.0625 milligauss per LSB resolution at 16-bit or 18-bit operation mode, and a 0.4 milligauss total RSM noise level. If all of these letters and numbers don't mean anything to you, just know that it allows for directional accuracy of 0.5 degrees in electronic compass applications. It has a max data range of 1000 Hz plus on-chip sensitivity compensation and on-chip temperature sensor. An integrated set and reset function provides for the elimination of error due to null field output change with temperature, and can be performed for each measurement periodically or when the temperature changes by a predetermined amount as the specific application requires. In addition, the set reset function clears the sensors of any residual magnetic polarization resulting from exposure to strong external magnets. The board itself is our standard 1-inch by 1-inch Qwiic Breakout with all the usual features. Dual Qwiic connectors, pins broken out at the standard 2.54 millimeters or 0.1 inches if you prefer the breadboard or SPI approach. If you care about how something moves and how to measure or control that movement, you probably want a 9DoF. And with our libraries for these two sensors, we make it real easy for you to get started. And you can use them for guidance, for positional control. They're great for vibration and movement detection. Balance, if you're building a two-wheeled Segway-style robot. They're used in fitness tracking equipment. I mean, let's face it, everything's better with a 9DoF. And now we have another way to help you get one in your next project with the new SparkFun Qwiic 9DoF IMU Breakout. Pick up yours over at sparkfun.com. And as always, stay safe, be kind, and happy hacking. I think I got that in one.
Damn!
Bam!
Damn!
I can fake some mistakes.
No, you just did.
Or I should retire. I should just quit now. Good night, everybody.